Hi, we are solving examples as part of geometric progressions. Let's look at this one. Find the value of n so that a to the power of n plus 1 plus b to the power of n plus 1 by a to the power of n plus b to the power of n may be the geometric mean of a and b. Now you know if a, b are two numbers, geometric mean is given by square root of ab. So can I write that root of ab as nothing but a to the power of half into b to the power of half? That means a to the power of n plus 1 plus b to the power of n plus 1 divided by a to the power of n plus b to the power of n, I should get equal to a to the power of half into b to the power of half. I have to find out what is the value of n. Now see here, when you go to geometric mean, what you have to prove is nothing but a to the power of half into b to the power of half. But if you look here, whatever is given to us, there is plus of two numbers here, and also we have plus again in the numerator and denominator. Now these two should cancel out. These two should cancel out. Not only that, from the bottom term or from the denominator, I should get 1 by root of AB, so that I can write it as root of AB. Let me repeat it again. If now we have here a to the power of n plus 1 plus b to the power of n plus 1 by a to the power of n plus b to the power of n, I have to take value of n such that whatever the additions I have, they should cancel out. Not only that, from the denominator, I should get 1 by 1 by root of AB, that's nothing but equal to root of AB. That means, I should have n value negative, then only, if I have n value negative, then only I can have 1 by positive. Then I can do 1 by x plus 1 by y. I can do 1 by x plus 1 by y. It becomes x plus y by xy. Or 1 by this whole thing will become xy. Now xy is nothing but I know a to the power of half and b to the power of half. That means my x and y should have negative values, right? It should be something like x to the power of something. So what I will do now is, I have to get here 1 by x plus 1 by y. That means my power should be negative, and it cannot be an integer like 1 or 2, then it will become complicated. You have to cancel out these additions. So what I will do, I will take n equal to minus 1 by 2. Let us see how it works out. I will say a to the power of minus 1 by 2 plus b to the power of 1 by 2, and here I will have minus 1 by 2 plus 1, and I will have b to the power of minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Now what is this? This is nothing but equal to a to the power of half plus b to the power of half divided by, see here, now I have 1 by a to the power of half plus 1 by b to the power of half. Now you can see when I take LCM, the additions will cancel out and I will get root AB to the numerator. So how it will become now? It is a to the power of half plus b to the power of half divided by, if you take LCM, that's nothing but equal to again a to the power of half plus b to the power of half whole thing divided by root AB, or a to the power of half into b to the power of half. Now this is nothing but equal to 1 by 1 by of root of AB, that's nothing but equal to root of AB. So that is what we have to prove. So what is the value of n then? N value will be minus 1 by 2. How we arrived at that? We know that GM is nothing but a to the power of half, b to the power of half. That means my n should be somewhere related to this. But if n is positive, this becomes 3 by 2, this becomes 1 by 2, not working out. I should have negative values. One minute, let me see, is there anything wrong here? Yes, there is minus missing. Okay, right. Now I have to have negative values as power in the denominator. That means n should be having negative value, then only I can cancel out my numerator and denominator. And I know I should cancel it out, and I should also get a to the power of half, b to the power of half. That means my n should be minus 1 by 2. So if I substitute minus 1 by 2, I see very clearly that everything cancels out and you get your root ab. Let us solve one more problem based on geometric means. Let's look at this example. If am and gm of roots of a quadratic equation are 8 and 5 respectively, then obtain the quadratic equation. Am and gm of roots of a quadratic equation. First of all, if I know the roots, how the quadratic equation looks like, we know that that's nothing but x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. This is my quadratic equation if I know the roots are alpha and beta. But what is given to us? Given to us that alpha plus beta by 2, that is nothing but equal to am, is equal to 8. And we also know gm, that's nothing but equal to square root of ab, is equal to 5. Now what I, it's actually square root of alpha beta. Let me just clear it up. Square root of alpha beta equal to 5. But what we need is alpha plus beta, and we also need alpha beta. So what I will do? I will say alpha plus beta is equal to 16, and alpha beta is nothing but equal to 5 square, that's equal to 25. So the equation will be nothing but x square minus alpha plus beta is 16x plus alpha beta is equal to 25. So the equation is x square minus 16x plus 25. That's about some simple examples related to geometric mean. We'll continue with geometric progressions. Thanks for visiting. Bye for now. See you in the next session.